THA, this year in the virtual edition, we discussed and presented the final results of the ASCEND study, which is an international phase 3 randomized study where patients with relapsed refractory CLL have been randomized to either be treated with acalabrutinib monotherapy or with a physician choice between idelalisib plus cetuximab or bendamustine plus cetuximab. Out of the 310 patients who have been enrolled, 155 were treated with acala monotherapy, while the other 155 were treated with the physician choice, the vast majority with idela plus rituximab, 119 patients, while only 39 patients were treated with bendamustine plus rituximab. In this final analysis, we confirm the benefit in terms of progression-free survival. After a longer follow-up, a median of 22 months, so with an additional 6 months compared to the last presentation of the interim analysis. And the PFS of acalabrutinib has an estimated 18-month PFS of 82% compared to 48% of the physician choice arm. This benefit is also maintained in patients with high-risk genetic features, so both in patients with the 17p deletion and/or p53 mutation, but also in patients with unmutated immunoglobulin genes. Remarkably, at this point, there is no advantage in overall survival, also because we have to recall that the patient could indeed cross over from the physician choice arm to acalabrutinib in case of progression. This is the efficacy of the drug in terms of safety. The longer follow-up did not show any unexpected adverse events, and indeed it is the safety profile of acalabrutinib monotherapy is confirmed with typical headache in 1/4 of the patient, a headache which is usually short-lasting, and then you can have also neutropenia or anemia. Among the adverse events of clinical interest, atrial fibrillation was present in 6% of the patient, and hemorrhage was interestingly in less than 1/3 of the patient, 29%, with major hemorrhage only in 3%. Hypertension was also low in 5% of the patient, and then we had second primary malignancies in 5% of the patient, if we don't consider the non-melanoma skin cancer. So in conclusion, the final results from the ASCEND confirm the findings at the interim analysis and support indeed the favorable efficacy and safety of acalabrutinib monotherapy in comparison to standard treatment for relapsed refractory CLL. On one side, a chemo-free treatment like idelalisib plus rituximab, and the other side, a classic and traditional immunochemotherapy regimen like bendamustine plus rituximab. Thank you very much for your attention.